Hi everyone, it's Carla from Casey Creates, and I wanted to come and show you my second design team project for the month of April for craft supplies for you. And unfortunately, I've had a terrible time trying to get these tall topiaries in frame. They're really not that tall. Let's see if I can, of course, I can't quickly find my tape measure. I dropped it down in that jar, but I'm gonna guess these are about 10 inches tall, the shortest one, and then the taller one's probably about 14 or 16 inches tall. That's this one. But what I'll do is I'll take some still frames and insert them so that you can get a better idea of what I did. But I was really having fun with the parchment flowers that you can order from Craft Supplies for You, and she's been running specials on these flowers for quite a while now. I think they're still where you can buy a big bunch of them for a flat rate of I think $25, but don't quote me on that. I would run over to the website and double check. But anyway, these parchment flowers are just beautiful because you can fluff them and really make them look real if you just give them a little TLC, because they're a little mangled in the bag. So I'll show you these. This is how they come typically in a little cellophane bag. Let's see if I can get these off. It's gonna be a little stubborn here. Anyway, I think you understand what I'm saying. I'm gonna try and, they are cool. This one is really wrapped tight. There we go, I got it. So see, they're really smushed, but if you just need a little putsy time, you can fluff them up and make the petals looser. And they just end up looking so pretty, embellishing things. So I, again, if you order them, a tip is order a bunch. Because I, again, underestimated how many it would take to cover this topiary. And I ran out of room. I mean, I ran out of buds in the same color. So I'm gonna actually order a few more because I kind of wanted a little tighter with more rosebuds. And again, I'll show you these standing upright in a still frame so you can get a better idea of what I did. But I took some gesso, and first I gessoed it just using a stippling kind of brush. And then I wanted it kind of to resemble stucco. And then I used this flexible acrylic paint. Anyway, it was on a clearance. It's called smooth satin, and I love it. I wasn't sure. I just grabbed it because it was clearanced out. And now that I've been using it on things, it's a perfect antique white. So I put that over the white gesso to get that kind of stone-looking surface. And then this one isn't quite finished, but since I ran out of the parchment flowers, I went ahead and used the paper flowers that I got from Craft Supplies for You. And I wasn't really happy with the lightweight quality because I thought they would only work well on something like cards or something delicate. But I found that just I dipped them in a little bit of this with I brushed some on. And then I rolled them in a little bit of glitter, and it just worked beautifully. And they've been stiffened up now, and they look nice on here. So the only thing I did differently on, well, these I glittered, these I didn't, but I did add some of the foliage from the parchment flowers. So I put a few leaves here and there. And then I put a pretty little embellishment of flowers and a pearl. And I don't know if Angie's watching, but I always call it my Angie Paisley effect when I pop a pearl here and there, because I love that she does that on her cards. So hi Angie, if you're watching. And then I think I'll just do this one and show you. So I have my Fabri-Tac. And this is not one of the craft supplies for you roses, but I wanted a slightly smaller one. So I'm going to use that one. And then this one, I think these are all little birdie. Just to kind of decorate the base of the pot a little bit. And then I'll stick my little rounded pearl right on top for a little extra dimension. So I'm going to do that. And then I have this, these are little satin roses that are strung. And on this one, I put the little loops of pearl. But I think on this one, I'm going to just stick a few of the satin rose loops all over it. I know the month of May is coming up and there's a holiday where they celebrate May Day. Is that what? I think it's May Day and they do the ribbons around the maypole. I really need to check my history and figure out and really understand what that's about, because I do know in elementary school they had certain girls that would dance around the maypole and the ribbons would go around it. And I always thought, why do they get to do that? Is that their heritage, or is, I mean, I never really understood, but they seemed to know what they were doing. So that's some homework for me. I'll check out what that's all about. This is actually stringing on here nicely without gluing. So I really like this trim. I don't know if you can see it. It's got the little white satin ribbon roses and the pearl, and it just gives the topiary a little more dimension. So these are my, this is my second project, like I said, for craft supplies for you. I'll leave a link to Julie's store. I've been really happy with the chance to design for her for the last couple months. I'm on for 3 months as a guest designer, and I hope you're able to pop over to her shop and get in on some of the great bargains as far as laces and trims. And I'll visit with you again soon. I hope you're all well, and thank you so much for watching. And stay tuned for some still photos so you can see better. Bye!